So in this video, we're going to show you how to put together a ground penetrating radar or GPR setup, a little bit of how you'd start to deploy it in the field and how you'd pack it up again. When it arrives to you, it's going to come in a box a lot like this. So we'll start by taking a look inside. So as you start your unpacking, it's a good idea to take a couple pictures during the process because the different pieces fit together here in a bit of a jigsaw puzzle that'll depend on the exact antenna that you have for the GPR and the GPS. So once you pull all the pieces out, and they may not be exactly the same as these, but you'll have, you know, the majority of these sort of things, you'll definitely have the cart. So this is like the back of the cart and the handle. These are the front wheels. This is what you would attach the GPS with. And these are different frequency of antennas. This is 250, 500, and 1000 megahertz. Those are batteries. We have the backpack with like extra cables and a laptop. This is the controller screen for the GPR. And at least you'll have one GPS. And possibly if you have a base station, you might have additional GPS as well. You're less likely to have this antenna, but if you're wanting a low frequency antenna, this is the 100 megahertz and it's larger. And this is what it looks like.
So I will go over the basic assembly of the GPR cart. You're going to start with the back of the cart, the antenna of your choice. This time we're going with a 250 megahertz antenna and the front of the cart. The first step I'm going to do is take out the thumb screws that attach the antenna to the front of the back of the cart. These are pretty easy to twist on and twist off, but they have a lot of thread, so they'll take a bit. Yeah, definitely do your best not to lose these. All right, next I'm gonna pick up the antenna by its mount. So there's the two ends of the poles that actually line up with the back of the cart. I'm just gonna slide them in to those. Gonna just make sure that they're well seated. And then take the front of the cart. You'll have two other posts that lines up with. All right, once that is done, while I'm holding the front of the cart, I can just tip it forward and sit down assembled. Before we start pushing it around, we need to put back in the thumb screws that we took out earlier. So while putting back in the thumb screws, be conscious of trying not to cross-thread them. Be a bit gentle. So as I'm putting them in, I'm just, you know, not putting that much force. If I feel like they're going in, they're getting stuck, just back them back out. Try realign the pole and then start again. Next, we're going to attach the 37-pin connector to the antenna itself. When they first come from shipping, they're going to have this sock on them with some foam, so I'm just gonna slide it off to expose it. And then as you look at this, there's gonna be a latch to help to secure it. Because it's such a wide connector, I'm actually going to just gently put it in, kind of rock it a bit back and forth to make sure it's seated right before I go over and actually latch it in place. So next, I'm gonna place the battery in the back of the cart. There's a strap with a buckle that it goes in between, so I'm gonna disconnect that first. And then just sit it back like this with the handle facing towards out of the cart. And then thread the strap right through the handle and just secure it in place with that. And then to the right of the battery is where you connect the cable that goes to the rest of the system. And then finally, we're going to attach the DVL itself, which is the video screen for it. It just slides on to the top of the cart. I can feel the latch actually go in place. And then from there, it has its own 37-pin connector that's under a sock. And I'm going to do the same as I did with the antenna. I'm going to line these up as best as I can to make sure that we don't get it crooked before ever attempting to do the latch. There we go. Now it's flush. I can turn the latch and it's sitting good. So next we're going to attach the GPS mast. To do that, I need to slide over these mount points for the mast itself over the antenna. These are known to be a pinch hazard, so definitely while you're doing it, just kind of have your hands away from it. I'm going to put two on the GPR mount itself and one on the back of the cart at the center. I'm then going to line up our actual GPS mast to the two holes left with it. I'll take a bolt and thread it through like that, and then use a wing nut to hold it in place. It's just a bit more convenient to just have the wing nuts facing outward instead of inward, and they don't take all that much pressure to hold it in place. All right, to keep our GPS mast from flopping around, there's a crossbar that will come with it. I will take out the pin for it, slide that into there, and then just put the pin back in before attaching it to the back of the cart with another bolt and wing nut. So for here, I'm attaching an M-LED rover that we have. We also have a couple other GPSs that can attach to it. But once it gets snug, it's secured in place, which is right about there. To connect our M-LED, I will use a special connector we have here that goes to a DB9 on the back of the noggin. Now I'll just screw that in place to lock it. If you're also pairing this M-LED with a base station for increased accuracy, you'll also attach a LoRa antenna, which also goes under one of the other dust covers on the GPS. And now that we have the whole cart assembled, we're just about ready to start surveying.
So even though the GPS won't be giving us real data indoors like this, I'm going to go ahead and turn everything on and make sure things are functioning properly before we head out to the field. So start by turning on the GPR screen here, hold it for a couple seconds, and then it'll take a few seconds to sort of boot up and know what's going on. So while that's happening, I'm also going to turn on the GPS, the buttons here, hold it till the side lights come on and start blinking, and that'll also take a minute or two to be ready. Now that everything is started, we're going to just check and make sure the main settings are correct. First thing to look at is that it's recognizing the right antenna and cart, so that it is a 250 megahertz antenna and it is a smart cart as opposed to other kinds, so that's good. Now I want to check the settings. I can go into tools, and then system configuration. If I wanted to adjust the scan depth, I could do that using scan depth. If I wanted to change the medium that I think I'm in, I can change the expected velocity under the velocity tab. But mostly I want to make sure that the GPS is correctly configured here. So this is an external GPS, and so I do need to change that to external. It should come correctly configured for the M-LID to be 9,600 baud rate, but it's always good to take a quick look and make sure the frequencies are matching there. I could run a GPS test, except for since I'm indoors, that won't actually show me anything, but I could do that one again once we get outside. So to get back to the main splash screen, I just hit 8 or exit until I get back to the pretty yellow noggin screen. There we go. So if you're heading in the field and you need to, say, transport this in a truck, you don't have to entirely take it apart and put it back in the box. There's just a couple pieces you need to take apart for safe transport. So first off, you would turn the screen off. You hold it for a couple seconds. And the same with the GPS. Hold it for a couple seconds. It'll power down. You would undo the cables. So I'm undoing this. I'm taking off the 37-pin connector, undoing the GPS, right, then you pull on this to get that off, and then you pull this pin down and you pull the screen up to take it off here. And then you take off the GPS mount with the three wing nuts here. Put them somewhere safe so you don't lose them. And then you can fold the handle down here. So you just pull this pin out, then you need to bend the handle down until the bar comes out. Then you fold the handle down like that, and then you can fold the post down on top. And then it's easy to lift into a truck. So we've come back out in the field because we want to do a GPR survey out here. Of course, before you come in the field, you always want to check the weather, make sure that all your batteries are fully charged. In this case, we've set up a base station so that it can talk to the rover on the GPR unit and have higher accuracy. That's optional depending on your needs. So now we're going to go ahead and do the GPR survey over this direction.
And we're going to start a survey here to try to find a sewer line here on this dirt road. To begin that survey, I'm going to hit line scan on the splash screen. I'm going to set the target depth that I want, and then I'll hit start. Take a bit for it to start up. Once there, I get to start pushing the cart forward, and it'll start updating on the screen in real time what it's seeing. So as it's moving, there's an odometer wheel down here at the bottom that turns with the back left wheel. That is actually what's measuring the distance it's actually traveling. And it's very important that that's actually still working, because if it's jammed or it's not touching the back wheel, it's not gonna update how far it's traveled. So sometimes you're actually gonna wanna switch out which antenna you're using in the field. Antennas with lower frequencies are really good at looking at deeper targets, but don't actually have that well of a resolution, while higher frequency antennas are able to look at shallower targets. We decided that we actually want to switch out for the 500 megahertz antenna right now in the field, so we'll show you how to do that. So first, we're going to take back off the GPS mast. And then we're going to take back off the mounts for as well off the antenna. I'm going to make sure that the noggin itself is off before I disconnect the 37 pin. And then I'm just going to unlatch it, pull it back, and then best spot to usually put it is just sitting right next to the battery. Then from there, I'm going to take out all four thumb screws. And then we're just gonna do the same as we did inside, where we slide off the antenna and then just put the new one on. So I'm going to rock the cart back. So all the weight's on the back. Take off the front wheels. Pick up the antenna by its mounts and just slide it off. Now that we got it back into separate parts, I just do the reverse again. I find the back of the antenna, which will have the 37-pin connector. Line that up with the back of the cart and slide it on by its mount. And then just to fix the front wheels the same way, just slide it all over the tubes, put it on, tip it forward. And now just put the 37-pin connector back in and all the thumb screws. And then from there, we're just gonna reattach the GPS mast, and I'm gonna slide these over the poles for the antenna. And you know they're at the right spot when they're actually centered to the antenna. There is an arrow on the side that also indicates that. And now that we have the GPR back on and with a new antenna, we can start scanning again. So I'll just go to line scan and then start. Set my scan depth, and we're ready to go.
So bringing it back from the field, we'd already taken some of the components apart, but now we'll show you how to take apart the rest of the cart and to carefully put it back in the shipping container for safe return. A lot of times when it's in the field, it will have picked up rocks. So you want to spend a little time cleaning these out of the wheels so they don't get loose and scratch things while it's in shipment. So the 37-pin connectors are very delicate and we want to take good care of them during transport, so we put these socks over them.
And now that's packed out, it's ready to ship back to Earthscope.